I condemn, I take the shield of faith and quench every fiery dawn. I take the shield of faith and quench every fiery dawn. Only you I serve. Holy, oh holy, only you I committed, only you I serve. I'm established in righteousness, and oppression is far from me. Yes, I've established in righteousness, and oppression is far from me. Holy, oh holy, only you I committed. Only you I serve. Holy, holy, only you I committed. Only you I serve. I use the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, against the enemy. I use the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, against the enemy. Holy, oh holy, only you I committed, only you I serve. I will serve you for pleasure.
Somebody give God some praise. Give him God some praise. Give him God some praise. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah one more time. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. Somebody say, my God, on the inside, I'm going to attempt to do this song before we pray the intercessory prayer and go into the message. I'm going to try to do My God is Awesome with you. I don't know if you know it, but if you know it, look at the inside of your program. We're going to worship the Lord right now. My God is Awesome. I'm going to ask Lady Sterling to just go ahead and lead on in this song, because if she don't lead, you know, I'm going to just go on and I'm just going to take off in my own way. I'm going to take off. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. My God. Oh, yes. We're going to pray. We're going to pray. We're going to pray. We're going to pray. Glory to God. You ready? You ready for me? Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My God is awesome. Oh, bless your name, Jesus.
Go ahead, my sister.
Yes.
My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keep me in the valley. Hide me from the rain. My God is awesome.
Oh, glory to God. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. We're going to pray. We're going to pray. We're going to pray. You'll be all right. All is well. Praise God. Praise God. Hey. Bow your hands with me. Towards heaven in your heart and your mind and your soul. Glory to God, for He is awesome. It's not about us, it's about God. Be glorified. And sometimes we will let self get in the way, but we cannot let self get in the way. We got to let the Spirit of God lead us in all things. Oh, glory to God. Jesus, I'm feeling at this moment that some of us, we are here, but we are struggling in the spirit. We are not there yet. We are not feeling the touch as yet. We are not feeling the presence as yet. We're right now just onlookers, but I want you to seek the Lord right now, because I want you to get from that realm of onlookers to the realm of worshiper. Mighty God, I thank you for you, what you have done today, and we thank you for bringing us here safely. Thank you, mighty God, at this moment I intercede on behalf of your people. But Lord God, we pray right now that you will remove self, Lord, and everything that is unlike you. God of heaven, I pray at this moment that you will touch each and every heart that is in this place right now, in this synagogue. Father, I want to pray for your grace and your mercies at this moment. But even more so, I want to pray for your daughter, Kiana, right now. I pray that you'll give her understanding. I pray right now, Father, that you'll touch her from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. I pray, God of heaven, you'll renew a right spirit within her. Let the joy of the Lord be her strength, Lord God. Yeah, mighty God, things might not have gone the way she expected it to go, but to God be the glory for great things He has done. We are together in this, Lord God. Mighty God, comfort her heart at this moment. Comfort her mind at this moment. Let not the devil take over. Let not the devil have any way with her. But God, I pray that you'll touch her heart, Lord. Touch her mind, Lord. Give her, Almighty God, a heart of encouragement, a heart of motivation, as she, Almighty God, make herself available to be used by you in the house of God. Almighty God, as she serve, I pray, God of heaven, that you will baptize her, Lord, with the power of your Holy Spirit and might. That, oh God, oh Father, the things that bothered her will not bother her anymore. But she'll smile, mighty God, and say to God be the glory. Let your will be done. Touch, mighty God, every sickness in this place, every circumstances in this place, every young man, every boy, and every girl, every child, every woman, oh God, every man in this place that is going through something. Something, mighty God, might not seem right, but oh God, I know you can turn it around. I know you can change things. Mighty God, I pray you'll shine your light right now in this place. Remove everything that is unlike you and let your will be done. Touch each and every one, Lord God, that has come. Father, may they not leave here the same way, but may they leave with a blessing, with an assurance. I thank you, Lord God, for Brother Green. I thank you for this young man who has came on board, Lord God. I pray that you be with them and keep them. I pray for this family that has come here, the young man, Lord God, on the drums, and the young man by his mom. I pray for the mother at this moment, Lord God. I pray for Brother Douglas at this moment. I pray for Sister Simmons at this moment, for Stephanie and for Sister Lyons, oh God. I pray, mighty God, that you'll touch them and that you'll be with them and remember them, God of heaven, wherever they are. I pray, God, for this sanctuary. I pray for this ministry. I pray, God of heaven, that you'll send us, almighty God. Help, my God, for my help coming from the Lord. Help on this side. Mighty God, there'll be worshipers, true worshipers, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for true worshipers, Lord. I pray for true ministers, Lord. I pray for musicians, Lord. I pray for choir leaders. Oh, mighty God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for technicians, Lord, in this place, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, rise up, oh God, your people to serve you. Rise up, your people, Lord, to live for you. Rise up, your people, Lord, to be who you want them to be. And we cancel, Lord, every plan of the enemy. We cancel, Lord, every sickness. We cancel, Lord, every powers of darkness. We cancel, Lord, everything that coming to block us up and to tie us up. We cancel it, Lord. We break every chain. We break every depression. We break every sickness. We break every sorrow. We break diabetes. We break our blood pressure. We break it, mighty God, in the name of Jesus. Reign, Jesus, reign. And let your will be done. Let your will be done. Touch. 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 My God. Let your will be done. Not my will, but your will. God of heaven, as we look forward for tomorrow to partake of the supper, God, make our hearts right. Make our minds right. Nothing is more important than sitting at the table of Jesus. Nothing is more important than to sup with him. Mighty God of Daniel, Jesus, as we drink and as we eat, Lord, we pray for healing in the body. We pray for healing in the body. We pray for life in the body. Sickness must go. Sorrow must go. Pain must go. Jesus. And every setback is for a greater comeback. Glory to God. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to his name. You may be seated. I want to give these to the young man who came in. Praise God. Thank you for coming through. Kiana, come on, get this to the young man here. Thank you for coming through. Compliments of Intercessory Ministry. Give you a CD. And we're going to give you a pen as well. Glory to God. A special pen. We want to thank you for coming. We thank you for blessing us with your presence today. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, praise God. It's going to get a little rocky right now. It's going to get tight right now. Time is going. Time is going as we're going to lift this one. Hear my cry, O Lord. Attend unto my prayer. My God, that too hard for them. That too high for them. Should I come and should I rewind and come again? Oh God have mercy. Come on, Lady Sterling. Take it away from me.
Hear my cry, O Lord. Attend unto my prayer.
Hey, hey,
from the end of the earth. Will I cry? Thank you.
Serving Jesus. Do I have a witness? I'm gonna go through the seven last phrases of Jesus. Are you with me? Some people will say the seven last words. Turn that mic off for me. Of Jesus. Some people will say the seven last words of Jesus, but I want to say it's the seven last phrases that he spoke before he gave up the ghost. Before he gave up the ghost, he spoke some words. And the words that he spoke are sound words. Words of life. Words of life. Words that will convict us. Words that will elevate us. Words that will cause us to repent. Words that will bring us to a place where we will say, Lord, I yield. Glory to God. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. That's coming from upstairs. That's all right. Praise God. Turn with me to the book of St. Matthew chapter 27. St. Matthew 27. And let's look at verse 46. Also, you might want to turn to Mark chapter 15 and verse 34. But Matthew chapter 27 and verse 46 says that it was about the ninth hour. And I'm going to share some things with you that is not what you know. But you see, when it says the ninth hour, we need to know what time of the day is it. What time of the day was it? Because you have the ninth hour, you have the sixth hour, and you have the third hour. And if I'm not mistaken, the ninth hour would be in the evening. Is that afternoon thereabouts? The ninth hour would be about the afternoon, because the third hour is early morning and so forth. And the sixth hour, and then you have the ninth hour going the afternoon into the evening, if you understand what I'm saying. So it'd be the afternoon going into the evening, the ninth hour. And this is the time of the night, or the evening rather, where Jesus Christ felt the pain the most. This is where, as you would say, the buck stops here. This is where crunch time is. Are you hearing what I'm saying? This is about what you call today the fourth quarter of the game. The last 3 minutes or so of the game. The crucial part of the game. But it's not a game for my Savior. So at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. And when we interpret it in English, it simply says, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? You see, at this moment, God cannot look on Jesus Christ. At this moment, he is full of sin. Sins not of his own, but sins of the world. At this moment, Jesus Christ is burdened down with the cares of this world. He's burdened down with your sin and with my sin. He's burdened down with the fact that he must die. And he's not guilty. Hello, you hear what I'm saying? You have been sentenced to be executed, but you are not guilty. My God, what a controversy. What a piece of excitement now. Because some mothers are crying and weeping for their child, for their boy child, for their girl child, for their loved one. Some wife is crying for her husband because she says he is not guilty. What time is it? Crunch time. What time is it? The ninth hour.
What time is it? Time to die. My God. But I was guilty. You were guilty. We all are guilty. We stood before Pilate Hall, before the judge and the jury. They began to try you. For some of you, you have been fornicating for a long time. Can I speak frankly? Some of you, you have been committing adultery for a long time. You're living it. Some of you, you have been backbiting for a long time. Some of you, you have been hating on your brothers and your sister for a long time. Some of you, you're vexed with the pastor for a long time. Some of you, you're vexed with the boyfriend for a long time. He won't marry you. And you're guilty. Some of us, when you're young, you steal mommy and daddy's sugar. You eat all the food before they come home, and you're guilty. They told you to come straight home from school. You find yourself at boyfriend and girlfriend yard. You find yourself at the movie. You find yourself playing at the park, and you're guilty. So the trial is right here before you. And they look at you and they say, how do you find the defendant? How do you find Master Joe? How do you find Sister Mary Jane? How do you find Byron Anthony Sterling? I hear somebody get up and say, guilty as charged. I hear every single one of them get up and they say, guilty. And I saw the devil coming. Don't you think the devil have no long pick or spark? But the devil decide to come. Death angels decide to come and to take me away. Because somebody says, guilty, guilty, guilty. But my Lord. Somebody say, my Lord. Jesus walked right on in. Jesus decided to come in and to mash up the Dalios. He decided to come in. He said, wait a minute. He said, hold on, Master. He said, hold on, Pilate. Thou dost say it. Whatever they say, thus said it. But as I stand before you, this gentleman, this lady, this sister, drop the charge. Lord have mercy. He said, hold on. I paid a price for them. He said, hold on. Don't execute Pastor Cummings. I got the ransom to pay for him. He said, don't just put a death sentence on Elder Charles. Ah, my God, don't you forsake him. Because you have forsaken me on the cross already for him. So give him a chance. Give him a second chance. Let him live. Drop the charges. I know he's guilty, but I'm willing to die for him. I'm willing to take the blow for him. Hello, somebody. You need to know what this is what Jesus did for you and for me. Oh God, am I being too strong here? He said, Eloi. If you go over to Mark, it said Eloi, Eloi. But my God, why have you turned your face away from me? If God should draw himself away from you today, where would you be? What would you do? If God should take himself away from you, what will you do? They decide to deport some of you today. They decide to lock some of you down. They decide to deny some of you. But I've got Jesus. Somebody say Jesus. I said, I've got Jesus. And you can't take him away from me. You may cancel the green card. You may take away the passport. You may stamp cancel on it. But I've got Jesus. You may take away the pens and the beamer. You
house with 5 bedroom, but I've got Jesus. Woo! You can't touch him. You can't take him away. My God. I might be down and out. I might not have what you got, but I've got Jesus. Go tell it on the mountain. Go tell it on the mountain. You may restrict me, because some of you right now, if you gotta go to the moon, you have to pay some big money.
Lord have mercy.
You think I hear fear from Jamaica to America? If you got to go to the moon, it's unfortunate man decide to go to the moon and cut it up too. Just like how they cut up the world. They cut up the world, peace here and peace there. Trinidad here, Guyana there, Africa there, United States there, England there. And they say, you know what?
Come over here if you think you're bad.
If I catch you, they say, you come over here. This is my land. But I look for a builder. Do I have some time to preach today? I say, who's maker? Oh, God have mercy. He said, I go to prepare a place that where I am, there you'll be also. A new world order, a new government. And if you don't repent, you cannot be there. But a new world order. A new city whose builder and maker is God. Yeah? Then I'll jump you out of business. Lord. Put on you out of business. Yeah? Queen Elizabeth, you out of business. God have mercy. Your riches don't know. Oh God, you have no more power. Your power catch cold. You have no more authority. Oh God. Can I preach to somebody? I said, the Savior will be the ruler. That's why Herod tried to kill him. Oh God, I wish I had some time. You see, when he raised, they peeled him off. They said, go tell them in another city. The disciple came and they stole him away. They took him. But before he died, another phrase he said, Father, forgive them. Are you with me, somebody? You want to know where that found? He said, Father, forgive them. Let me tell you where that found. Where it found? Luke 23:34. He said, Father, have mercy upon them, for they know not what they do. Somebody ever locked you up in their own house and God will left you? And they think that you in there suffer. But if they only knew that you were having a nice time, God have mercy, somebody say, long time, me never have no nice time. But here I whoop in the refrigerator, I help myself, I turn on the smart TV, and I help myself. You thought that you meant bad for me, but God turned it around. Oh God have mercy, can I preach? Your girlfriend, she thought that she took away the one piece of man that you were looking to marry her. You're buying clothes, you're buying shoes, you're buying new car, and you set him up for yourself. But then your girlfriend, she met him one day, and all of a sudden, oh God. But God, I'm somebody better. Oh Lord, somebody say, ouch. God had somebody better for you. You thought that he was silver and gold, but here comes a knight in shining armor. He's wrapped up and tangled up in the power of the Holy Ghost. You can have him, my dear, but I've got someone. He's sweet, I know. Better must come one day. I won't let a good thing prevent me from a better thing. Lord have mercy. Can I speak the truth? Oh, wait a minute. He said, listen, man, they don't even know that what they are doing, they are fulfilling the scripture. They don't even know that what they are doing me a favor. Oh, God. The devil, he thought he had me. Hello. Hello. The devil thought he had you. Hmm? You are about to go over the cliff. Hello. You know what I'm saying?